Hey, what is up guys? My name is Cosmin, and in today's video, I'll show you how to create this flat illustration inside Illustrator in just a couple of steps. If you're new to this channel, this is a place where every week I'm trying to help graphic designers get better by sharing my own creative process. I needed an illustration that showed how comfy a cup of coffee can be, so I've sketched out three simple ideas. You can watch some bits of the process here, and in the end, I've chosen this one. I'll first need to start with creating a new document inside Illustrator. So let's name it Coffee Illustration and hit Create. Let's add the Pathfinder window. You can find it here. And make sure that under View, you have Smart Guides enabled and disable Snap to Pixel. I just don't like when my pets are not exactly where I want them to be. And I'll need to add a sketch inside the document. So you can either drag it directly to your canvas, or if you have it inside Photoshop, just like me, you can hold the layer clicked while switching between the apps and place it wherever you want. I'll just select and transform it. Make sure you'll hold down the Shift key to keep everything in the same proportion and don't distort the illustration. I'll want to have it in this corner and lock it up there. So let's head to our layers window and find it there. I'll rename it to Image. And I'll want to lock it in, so I can't move or select it anymore. Just hit that. And once I'm zooming in, I can start using the pen tool. Let's select it. And I'll want to choose a color for the outline. Blue is not so good, maybe an orange, yeah, this one. Increase the weight a bit of the outline. And just start tracing each line that makes the composition. I'll start with something on the inside, like the hand. Once I've traced everything, I'll quickly switch to outline mode by holding down Command or Control and the letter Y, and this will help us see if there are any paths that are too long. You'll want each end to intersect with another path and not have it go over it. I'm looking very closely, but I think that was the only one. I honestly really like going into outline mode because you have a clear view of the composition. I'll switch back, and once I'm happy with the result, let's just click and select everything. And while holding down the Alt key, I'll create a duplicate and move it to the right. I immediately want to make it a bit narrower, so to do that, I'll select everything and drag that anchor from the right a bit to the left. Now, I'm not sure about the hair, so I'll try and use it to fill up the space on the right and give it more volume, so let's adjust it. Using the pen tool, I'll start adding more anchors and have that path connect with the leg. Now try to avoid having too many paths intersect or have any that are really close to each other. That way your flat illustration won't have any visual tension and have a clean look. I'll want to start smoothing out the paths I've initially created, so for that I'll use the Smooth tool. Let's select everything and you can find it there. And select the path you want and just click and drag on top of it to make it look more natural or to at least adjust the curvature. I'll want to create some very basic shading, so select the lines which are now expanded, copy and paste them in front and hit the merge button. Using the eyedropper tool, I'll sample the blue color and that will fill everything up. I'll just want to keep the face, neck, arms and feet and apply white on them. So I'll double click to enter the group and select just those elements by holding down Shift. Release and hold Shift again and do another selection, which will include the other elements and remove them. To create the shadow effect, I'll just hold down the Alt key and drag the whole group to the side and create a duplicate. I'll want to apply a different color to get a better look, maybe this red. And you can adjust the positioning of these elements using the arrow keys. Let's zoom out, and I can see I'll need to do some adjustments with the shape at the feet. That's because it overlaps the arm. Using the direct selection tool, I'll move those elements out of the way so they don't intersect with the hand, because I'll want to merge them. Just click on each individual one and move them or use the handles. Once that's over, I'll select both of them, both groups, by holding down the Shift key and eventually merge them. I only want to have the white elements left, so double click in the new group and select them and remove the other ones. Now I can simply just apply a color. I'm not sure what I'm going to use, maybe the dark pink, but it came out pretty cool. I'll want to do a quick preview of the outline so you can see how simple this illustration really is. Honestly, the hardest part was to keep it simple. During the process, I found myself wanting to add more details, but that's pretty much the opposite of what you should be doing. Now, in the end, I've still experimented for a bit and did a couple of variations. You can find the links in the description below. You can download them for free. And hopefully you've learned something new today. If you've enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button and subscribe for more. Until next time, take care, guys. Bye.